quiet, it won't be safe, and it won't be calm.
It's run up and down lots of corridors!
That was the one!
He's turned off to the right, Brigadier.
Locking phasers on target.
They're locking phasers. Ray shields.
Fire!
But I tell you what it will be. I tell you what it will be. A trip of a lifetime.
Yes, indeed, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, indeed. Good evening, guys. Good morning. I hope you're all doing well wherever you are. I am gasping for a cup of coffee. And I was just a bit off a mish. I hadn't set up the Rumble stream properly, and it wasn't streaming to Rumble. Let me go and check if we are good to go on the Rumbles right now. Hang on, we'll go check over there. Hang on. So I had to like disconnect. Oh yeah, no, Rumble's totally working. That's good news. That is good news. One on now. Did I add a sweetener into my coffee? That's the next question. I'll go. I'm not sure. You know what? A little bit extra can't hurt, ladies and gentlemen. Definitely cannot hurt. How is everybody? I hope you're all doing well. I am recovering, baby. I am in recovery mode. Listen. Yesterday I was really jiggered. Yesterday I was really happy because on Sunday, big Jewish holiday, where you get very very drunk, we get completely shit faced, which I did, ladies and gentlemen. Which indeed I did because you know what? I am a strong adherent. To my religious values, but it's a strange holiday, Purim, right? It is a strange holiday. People dress up a lot, so let me show you some pictures. These are real pictures, right? I don't know where this is from. It's probably a place called Meshrim, I would guess. But yeah, this is normal, right? This is normal what you see in Israel, right? Except if you go to like the non-religious areas. And people dress up, but everything has the word slucky in front of it. It kills me, right? Every insanely hot 16-year-old who looks like they're 27 dresses anything they like, but it's got to have the word slutty for it. Slutty bunny, slutty tulip, slutty cup of coffee, yeah, slutty water. Everything is slutty. In the religious areas, not so much. So this one's funny. This one I like a lot. You see? A lot of time they don't know what these costumes are. they're unaware. Also, for this Jewish holiday of Sukkot, which happens around September, October time, we have these little huts that we live in outside, and we decorate them, and we use them. Essentially, it's Christmas decorations. Nobody really realizes apart from me. So we've got this one as well. A bit of Spidey. At the Wailing Wall. So that's Purim, right? Purim, yeah, you go to the afternoon, you head over to friends and you get steaming drunk, which I quite... Normally, I go for tequila, right? Normally, I go for tequila. This year, I went for a very nice bottle of delicate sweet wine. It was really good. It wasn't port sweet, but it was, like, really, really nice, like, really, really pleasant. And, you know, the big thing with Purim, right, the big social thing, is your shalok manot, right? Your shalok manot are these little gifts of... you have to have two different types of blessing in it. So you could have one blessing for nuts, another blessing for cookies, another blessing... Yeah, how many blessings are there? You've got 1, 2, 3, 4... Over food, I think there's, what, 4 or 5? Something like that. So anyway, our ones are relatively famous, right? Our ones do pretty well. People like getting out. So this year, our theme was the... there's so many things I got to fill in. This year, our theme was the week one gets married, you have like these celebrations every day. And the one on Sabbath is a big one. And we were going to have like this party on Sabbath called a Kiddush. We invite everybody over. So we didn't do that for my son's wedding because he got married in the middle of a combat zone. Right? So what we did instead, we put this together, which was the food they would have had at the party without that they didn't come, right? That we didn't have. So you have in the background, you see a picture of the festivities. You know, lots of Israeli flags this year. Oh my God. Everyone, Shalom Mona, was very, very super duper patriotic. Here's a bunch of them being raided up, ready to go out. If you're lucky, you've got like a little bottle of Southern Comfort, a little bottle of whiskey. If not, you got the cheap grape juice. So there you go. So there, by the way, we have, we have the many different kugels. We have the Yishalmi kugel, which is this one over here. Yishalmi kugel, right there. And you have, which is essentially, you boil up fine noodles and you mix them with brown sugar in a pot. You mix them in a big pot with brown sugar, I think pepper maybe, I don't know, and then bake it so it sets and then you have it in little slices. And the other one is potato kugel, very good. Ground up potatoes with salt and egg fried. Look, can't be bad, ladies, and can't be bad. So, anyway, so Purim happened, and I did. I got, I had a stagger home. Oh man, I miss the stagger home. Right, that's one of my favorite bits of my youth. The stagger home. Because I used to live in Bushey, which is like the furthest from the northernmost point of London before you get to Watford, right? And the bus, what was it? The 142, right? Used to stop at the top of my street and you had to go down this alleyway, right? There was a pub. What's the name of the pub at the top? Anyway, you had to go down this street on a real sharp incline. And then I was at the end of the street. So, yeah, no, I had many a stagger home, right? A stagger home, especially with takeout engine. Oh, nothing says that it's 1989 and everything is good. But then staggering home with the takeout engine. Anyway, so I got awfully blotto. I was kind of out of it all of yesterday as well. Now, weird thing, in Jerusalem, I think it's only in Jerusalem, they do the holiday of Purim the day later because it's cities that were walled in the time of Yeshua, son of Nun, right? And Jerusalem is the only one. And boy, there's been, interesting energetic fluctuations, I would say, in the world. Like, everything seems to be coming out good for Trump. It's really bizarre, and I think that's a barometer of the light versus darkness war. Apparently, True Social, because he has so many Trump people buy it. By stock in it, he's got an extra $4 billion. So I don't know. He doesn't seem as cash poor as what was being reported because he had this absolutely corrupt and insane. I mean, I don't want to go into the story again. I talked about it too many bloody times. But this absolute insane judgment against him. Just because, and it with no trial whatsoever, it blows my mind. This is like real third world. Putin apparently got 85%, 87% of the vote. Why didn't you just say 100 at that point? But you know, this seems to be exactly the same sort of thing that Zelensky or Putin will do. I don't think Democrats want elections, right? That's what I think. I don't think Democrats want elections. They don't like people being able to choose who they want to run the country. And yeah, there's just a lot of weirdness going down, babe. A lot of weirdness going down. I saw there's a bunch of Doctor Who articles we're going to get today. New Doctor Who magazine comes out on Thursday. Man, that was quick. That was really quick because, Doctor Who magazine is such tat now. Right, I mean, it really is. It took a few issues, but yeah, let's have a quick look. One second. Firstly, here's the cover for next issue. Oh man, I like all of this is just a PR. Everything they do is a PR disaster. I feel like Rusty Davis is in a field of rate. okay, one second. He's in a field, right? Everything he does just goes horribly wrong. Because I guess he just makes lots of dumb decisions. So on set with Millie Gibson, we know you fired her, right? We know that everything you said, oh, she's so marvelous. Oh, just imagine, so marvelous. We know you fired her. And this is a boring-ass cover, right? This is a boring-ass cover. Oh, man. Doctor Who magazine is not what it used to be. And is it worse or better? Let's do an AP, right? Let's look at it. We'll do pocket mags. Let's look at the latest issue. Again, new issue comes out tomorrow. And then we'll compare it to a Jodie issue, right? Let's see which one's worse. Because it's kind of surprising. So we'll start from continue from the start. Right, so again, what a boring ass cover. What a lazy ass cover. I it's just like, yeah, this would be okay if you were in sixth form, right? But this is just a lazy ass cover. Comparing it to, let's go look at some Doctor Who magazine. My magazines. Not now. Is there anything I can just view Doctor Who magazine? Show more. We'll go back. Okay, all these covers seem a lot better. Right? I mean, okay, this is a bit shit. But all these covers are, like, so much better. And then you got Jodie. But, like, all these covers really are, like, so much more innovative. Right? Except when you lean into the current era. So, What was in this issue, which you can completely forget? I found it completely forgettable, right? Completely forgettable. They remember the Valley of Michael Jason, absolutely brilliant as always. Oh look, more not straight people, right? Oh, what a shock! Appearing Paul Neary liked him a lot for a reason. Facebook again, some other magazine. Oh, shut up, Russ, about your best week of your life. Fuck you. Mate, just fuck you. Honestly, genuinely, with every fiber I'm being, fuck you. I don't want to hear about your best week of your fucking life. Make some decent fucking Doctor Who. If you can't make decent fucking Doctor Who, find somebody you can and go away. Right? Stasis Cube? Frozen Incident Time. Oh, that's actually quite a nice feature. I like that. That sounds nice. Right? But then, okay. Goblin Crew. Who gives a shit? Okay, nobody liked the goblins. Right? I did, and I say I like them, I didn't mind them, right? But nobody really liked the goblins, right? They were just like, they didn't take off. They never went, oh, wow, so cool, right? Nobody. These were forgettable throwaway villains, because, well, duh. Are you surprised they're forgettable throwaway villains? And I like the Goblin King. I don't know, may have looked good in pre-production art. This kind of looks stupid to me. I know. Now, again, I don't want to rank in it too hard because, you can always have a shit idea every now and again. That's why. The trouble is, I really just think the only idea they have through the running through their heads right now is queer representation. Nothing else really seems to matter. What's this? The latest issue of Doctor Who hits the newsstand. Yeah, Doctor Who party! And then we got two pages. Then we got about the Doctor's costumes. Oh, God. You know, I have to tell you, the more I see Shooter's smug fucking smile, the more I fucking hate this Doctor, right? He is just, oh, narcissistic moron. Gives me a headache. In that trailer, Millie Gibson's the only one who actually was acting like a human bloody being. Right, okay, Neil Patrick Harris, he was pretty darn good. The goblins couldn't give a shit, right? Yeah, look, shoot, I'm sick of you posing all the fucking time. I really am. Like, again, this it doesn't really strike me as Doctor Who to me, right? I'm sorry, mate. I really wanted to give you I was so on board for you, right? All about see, I would have been up for this article if it wasn't about Christy fucking D, right? Who is just like nails on a fucking chalkboard. Tell you, that weird smile never changes. Like, never changes. Look, there she actually looks like a human being. So, weird thing about Christy D, or Crystal D, is that, who was it? Someone was telling me that they watched their podcast, not the official Doctor Who one, but another one, and there's just nothing in it to really grab anybody's attention. It's because Christy D doesn't have to work hard to get herself in the media, right? She's got the right politics, the right sexuality. Okay, and she's in. Yeah, more kind of weird throwaway articles that would do better in Hello Magazine. Yeah, look, this magazine is much more like Hello Magazine now than Doctor Who magazine. The diet of Doctor Who, food plays an important part in all allies. BB Human and Beth Aiden cooks up a menu fit for a Time Lord. Oh, fuck. The diet of Doctor Who. Nothing in this in any way is interesting me in any way, shape, or form. Man, I wish I was collecting these, though. Right? I really wish I collected these because these look really good. Especially the 88 one. Oh, man, I should have collected it. So this is another lackluster article. What is this? Paul Kirkley seeks... I'll say these are like extra bits of interviews. Okay. Again, oh, God. Ben Cook. I can't get over what a tosser this guy looks like. I love that he always tries to look cool. Ben, mate. Ben, you're a loser. I hate to tell you. You're 45 and you dress like you're 18, mate. In all fairness, this must have been 15 years ago. So, you know, you're only 30. So, this is what offcuts of Doctor Who magazine. Time space visualizer. Oh, God, fuck off, Jody. Why is this in a different space, a place that should it better at the front? Who's in Constellation from Doctor Who? Psychological written by Peter Harness. Oh, you can tell, right? You can tell. It's a really strong story. Ah, Peter Harness wrote it. It really shows. It genuinely shows. A teeny article about the Valiard. Teeny article about the ad for season 16, which or season 15, which I haven't got yet, still in the mail. The comic strip, I find this art, Elise Sullivan, the art is lackluster. Elise Sullivan's just okay. This is like everything of the current era of Doctor Who. Old people who don't have what it takes anymore to pull it off, right? This is exactly the current era of Doctor Who. A bunch of old folks who just do not have the drive or the innovation to pull anything off anymore doing Doctor Who, right? So look, I'm waiting to find anything of any, that's a good article. Nothing, right? Nothing. Fact or fiction, well, that's been going for a while. You can't really lay claim to that. And reviews, get me the fugitive Doctor TARDIS and Doctor model. Yeah, everybody wants that. Blimey. I mean, I wonder which landfill is bigger, that or the Rose Tico action figures. I don't know. You the people decide. I'm going through this. I'm literally getting bored looking at it, right? It's like, this is a boring bloody issue. Fine. So let's go back in time to, let's go back to early Jodie. Right? Well, I see that, you're like, okay, let's go over here. Very good cover. Do you notice how much better a cover that is? And this is, again, deep in the Jodie era, right? This is a much stronger cover. It's actually, it's well photoshopped together. It doesn't seem lazy, right? That's what this new era of Doctor Who magazine looks lazy, and it's coming out on Thursday. Doesn't it look lazy? Yeah, it does. Anyway, so this, there just seems to be a lot more going on here, right? Production notes, well. Again, what can you really do? Jodie in the closet. Do you remember Jodie in the closet? God, this was boring. I remember Chris Chibnall writing this lengthy thing about them doing it, and it... Like, who gives a shit, right? Who gives a shit? Countermeasures, don't think we'll be seeing that again. Time Lord Victorious. Remember that? Hoi, my boy. But again, look, this whole... So far, I'm what? 10 pages into this issue, and it's much more exciting. And it's from a very bad era, right? It's from a very bad era. Public Image. Do they have the overnights? The live figures? 2.27. Even Spyfall got more than the live figures do today. 2.27. Oh. But again... what's this? It's only trying for an extraordinary feature. Rusty, okay, this looks like thought has gone into it, right? Fun Photoshop. This is fun reading. Man. This is so much better. Okay. Theme and variations. Second. Okay, so interview with second. Again, but look at it. It's still better designed. Much more energy going on here, isn't there? Right? There's a lot more energy going on. Am I reading it? I don't know. The thing about the lockdowns, the watch on. But again, these are things that were interesting in the fandom. David, was it Collinson? Everyone's interested in hearing from Neil Gaiman out the TARDIS. But okay, look, there's a lot of interesting shit in this. Things for lockdown. Artwork significantly better. Who was this? Russ Leach? Significantly better. No, Martin Geraghty, Russ Leach. Well, look, they look like they spend a lot more money on it. Right? And again, this is shit that I would never buy in a million years, these reprints. Case of Androzani. Again, you can't really go, oh, I mean, that's it must be about the same. Right? This is kind of a fun little feature as well. But this is when they were dealing. This they basically put this into say there's no such thing as canon. This was the ripping up a canon thing. Reviews. Ah, oh, man, look at this piece of art they made for this. Isn't it gorgeous? Isn't it marvelous? Season 14. One of my favorite Blu-ray box sets. Right. Liza Captain Jack. But yeah. Okay. Look, I am saying that this is a vastly superior issue. Susan's War, that was great. A vastly superior issue. I don't understand why it's so crap, right? I genuinely have no idea why it is so crap today, but it is. Anyway, that's coming out on Thursday. This whole era is just, it's a shit show, mate. It is an absolute shit show. Where should we get to before we do the, no, we'll do that in a minute. I'll play this before we get to the chat. It's kind of fun. Actually, no, before we do that, we'll do this. So, you know, thing about this holiday Purim is everybody wears masks. You know why everybody wears masks? Because we want to demonstrate that our inner self is not the same as the outer self we project. Yeah, we project who we want to be rather than who we are to a great extent. But yeah, it's an idea that we are masks, reality is masks. I found in recent days the mask is completely falling off. Check this out, right? This is absolutely mind-blowing from CNN. What else is this? Yeah, here we go.
Do you feel like Elon Musk is going to get pressed to get in there one way or another?
There's either a red wave, this is where America is doomed. I think most people agree with that now. Imagine four more years of this getting worse.
Well, it would be good for Elon Musk. That's certainly true because, you know, he'll have some more trouble in the Biden administration if there's a second Biden administration around a bunch of things. And so Trump would be a savior for him in that regard because he would lay off of him and let him continue to do what he's been doing.
Okay, so this is incredible. Notice they have no self-awareness that they just said they're fascists, right?
I'm sorry. We can't let that one slip. You just said Elon Musk will have troubles if there is a second Biden administration for a bunch of things, and that if Trump wins, he will let him continue doing what he's doing. What is Elon Musk doing aside from running successful companies and not doing anything illegal? Because the only thing that made people like you, the left and the Biden administration, change their tone about Elon Musk is that he turned X into a free speech platform. So to me, what you just said sounds like a threat. It sounds like if Biden wins, he's going to go after Elon Musk because he's providing free speech. Am I wrong for that assumption?
That's for sure. Thank you very much.
It's bizarre to me people don't feel they're in like Soviet era Russia, right? It's insane. So, and we got this insanity through every strata of our universe. I'm watching the three body problem. I'm quite enjoying it, right? I don't like that it's a serial rather than a series. I like episodic drama, right? Episodic drama, I think, is great. This is not episodic drama, but it's not bad, right? It's got a lot of things in it I'm finding interesting. But the first thing I really found interesting was the depiction of the Cultural Revolution in the 60s in China, where you have, again, this is not a spoiler. This happens in the first 2-3 minutes. You have a science teacher come out, wearing a dunce hat, and they tell him to renounce the ways of science, right? Renounce science and believe in the party, right? And that is so much like where we are right now. It doesn't matter what science is. If science says that gender is not mutable, it doesn't matter. Then science is bigoted, and if you believe in that science, you're a bigot. This guy is beaten to death. This professor beaten to death because he won't say there is no evidence to prove or disprove God's existence, right? So he's literally beaten to death, right? During a struggle session in front of a crowd, his wife denounces him and says, "Thank you to the revolution," right? This is where we are right now. This is totally where we are right now. So look at this. From Lady Gaga, which I really feel is a ominous sign.
We need you. We need your family. We need your friends. We need your heart. Vote like your life depends on it.
Well, listen, darling, we need your head. We need you to look around, right, and go, "Oh my God, the world's on fire. We've screwed up in every way and we've been wrong about everything." But no, you're too busy using your heart. Oh, we feel so good about ourselves. Oh, we do.
Or vote like your children's lives depend on it.
Darling, you don't have children, do you? Right? Let's look at, does Lady Gaga have children? Let's have a look. I don't know. I don't think so. Lady Gaga. And yeah, it's amazing, right? It's amazing. People have, see, 37 years old, does she have any kids? People have no conception of family or children, always want to lecture you about how to raise your children because they know better, right? Then no, she's not married. Not married, no children. What do you know about children, darling? Like, honestly, what do you know about raising children?
Because they do.
No, they don't. No, they don't. I'm sorry. The trans ideology that you are advocating for is more likely to destroy children than to help them.
And to all the women and all the men with daughters and sisters and mothers, everybody, no matter how you identify, now...
Okay, we identify as human beings, right?
Now is your chance to vote against Donald Trump.
Oh no! What about world peace? Oh, and unlimited money. Oh no! No more equal opportunity, like the improved opportunities for minorities in the job market because everything was so good.
A man who believes his fame gives him the right to grab one of your daughters or.
Excuse me, darling. You're in the music industry. You want to tell me that you, Lady Gaga, and everybody else in your industry hasn't made sex transactionable? Excuse me, you're a degenerate. You're an absolute degenerate who has removed any idea of morality and family from the world, right? Doggedly so, like a fucking moron, right? And you're lecturing the world about morality?
Or sisters or mothers or wives by any part of their bodies. Vote for Joe. He's a good person. Thank
you. Oh, he's raped his daughter, you dumb cunt. Have you ever seen his children? Have you ever read Ashley Biden's diary? Oh, no, but that will make you feel bad.
Thank you.
Expect more hilarious celebrity tears, because there's going to be a lot more hilarious celebrity tears over the next year. Oh, and I think they're going to be someone say, but here, one second, just so we're clear. This is what she's advocating for.
Like to be trans and work with children, but not pass as the gender you identify with?
No, that's a no to everything, right? I don't want to know what's about me, what it's like to be trans. You're a woman, darling. You don't look like you're trans to me. It looks like you're wearing makeup. It looks like you're a woman, right? It looks like you identify as a woman and you're just a fucked up girl. I am sorry. Now, I don't know if you do identify as a woman or not, right? But and why are you working with young children if you're like, got this deep confusion about personal identity?
Let me tell you. I work with preschool age children, about 3 to 4 years old.
You should not be near preschool. I mean, look in. Hi, I'm just a happy, smiley person. You should not be forming these young people's opinions.
I guess my boss sent out an email to like the staff and the parents of my room, letting them know that I'm trans and like what pronouns I identify with and stuff.
Fuck me, I'll be homeschooling in a second.
Worker's great. She has never misgendered me. And when I'm in different rooms...
I don't know what gender you are. You look like you're pretending as a woman. You look like a chick, chick.
Some of the kids will ask me, like, are you a boy or a girl? Because my hair is kind of like a mid-length, but it's short enough that it applies.
Okay, they're just asking you that to make you feel good.
So the kids' logic of, like, boys have short hair and girls have long hair kind of...
What's wrong with that? What's wrong with boys and girls being different?
Thing. On my first day in the room, one of the kids asked me how I'm a boy if I have this thing. And then she pointed at like her nose where my piercing is. I've actually had kids correct other kids on my pronouns, saying that he's not a she, he's a boy. And like correct other kids. It's so cute. I've seen.
It's not cute. It's not cute. It's child abuse, right? It is child. It's like teaching a kid the word for banana is veiny bangstick. Right? All his life, right? All his life. The kid, you just, and don't say anything about it. Just don't make a big deal. Just say veiny bangstick instead of banana. Veiny bangstick, veiny bangstick, veiny bangstick. So then, first day the kid's in school, he goes, looks at the kid eating a banana, said, man, that is a nice looking veiny bangstick. Can I get my lips around it, darling? Right, that's child abuse.
Parents correct their kids too. The other day I was leaving work at the same time as one of the kids, and she was talking about me to her mom, and she was like, yeah, like, no, but she doesn't, whatever, whatever. And then the mom was like, yeah, like, he doesn't do whatever, whatever, and, like, kept talking. And I was like, that's just so nice.
Okay, it's all about being validated. Darling, you need a good man to go look after you. I hate to be one to, you know, good man, consensually, obviously, to get inside you and take you to heaven and back, right? And look after you. And I think your life would be so much better. It wouldn't be like these insane grins like, hi, I'm not crazy. I'm currently normal. No, this is crazy eye crazy. Yeah, leave us alone, darling. Leave all the kids. Go have your own kids, right? Go and have your own kids, destroy them, and then move on with your life. Man, oh, man. Yeah. So, look, Lady Gaga, thank you for your life lessons, right? Shut the fuck up. Oh, how about that? Just shut the fuck up, Lady Gaga. You know, and again, yeah, I'm hoping that the tides are turning, and once again, we will be able to say hot chicks is a thing that we espouse, right? Millie Gibson looking fantastic. It was a bit tough going for a Regency Millie, right? I had to go through a few different options. Getting the hair right was tough, right? It was tough. This was the closest. Right, but it was, she looks awfully good, I say. But yeah, not quite sexy enough, right? I think you needed a sort of shorter skirt. But that one works quite well. See, now we're about more like 1930s kind of Millie over here, right? Getting closer over here. Was this the one I used? Hang on, was that one I used? No, that wasn't the one I used. This was the one I ended up using. So I don't know, I think this one... Well, I don't like a hand up like that. I think this one's better. Which is why I use it. So how are we going to go? We've got a bunch of doctors. Clockwork Droids return. Oh, what the fuck. So apparently Moffat's episode is a sequel to the Clockwork Droids. Okay, a rumor so dull and boring it can only be from the current era. Three money problem. Holy crap, this is actually quite good. It is actually quite good. I'm amazed, right? It is amazed. Disney bitch slapped. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. The Nelson Peltz bid is taking them down beautifully. Love it. Love every moment of that. Why does everything from this new era seem tired and stale? Because other than queer representation, they have no ideas. That is all true. That is sadly is all true. Fine, let's get to the chat, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get to the chat. The only star is here. Was the biggest thing that he that puts him off in the new series is Jinx Monsoon. And that the half a second you saw of Jinx. Yeah, let me see if we can pull that up. The half a second you saw of it was freaking awful. Right? Like it was shockingly bad. Wait, do I have it? Did I get rid of the teaser? Okay, one second. No, that's just a date teaser. Ah, who gives a shit? I can't. But yeah, like she looked like a Muppet. It just looked ridiculous, right? I think this series is gonna be epically bad, right? I think it's gonna be really bad. I hope it really fails hard. Bigger than puts me off is Rossi Davis as P.D. Rich. P.D. Rich is not wrong there. P.D. Rich is not wrong. He's drank too much of the Kool-Aid. Yes, he has. And he's become an imbecile. The only thing that is likely to be good is Millie. And as she's been booted, I'm not even going to try to watch the Storm Survivors, Darren M. I'm more interested in how it's going to appeal to the normies. I don't think at all. I don't think it's going to go down well at all. Right? I think the rollout, right? The rollout that they're doing on Euro, right? On the 11th of two episodes, so dumb, such a dumb idea, and all basing around New York time. I mean, like, yeah, we're gonna roll it around Eurovision, but we're gonna space it all around New York time. But okay, there we have to. Brendan's got a theory that this is all in a parallel universe, but what he keeps saying on the after show makes me believe that this isn't the case. I don't watch the after show. I can't do the BBC stuff, right? I don't know who Brendan is, right? I can't do the BBC stuff. It's so bad. Bobby needs only 5 years. Shooty comes across as Dr. Ego in the beginning of the trailer. I got the whole world at my fingertips. It does feel like it, doesn't it? Right, it's all about him. Right, it's all about him. That's a Russell line. Let's see. Do I have the trailer? I thought I had the trailer somewhere. Hang on. Did I put it in this folder? One second. Because I had. Oh, one second. I have a whole folder of trailers. Is because in there now? Trip of a Lifetime. No, Parallel Series 10. Next Doctor trailer 2008. I think this is all. These are all the old ones. Fine, I'll download it. Ah! Ay caramba. There we go. Doctor Who. Doctor Who. Oh, God. As I sit, I go, oh! How awful. This was a really bad trailer. Hang on a second, doink. I'm amazed how bad it was, right? I'm amazed like how how much it failed on so many levels. Yeah, well, let me grab it. Here we go. Doink. Press the wrong button. Share screen. Share screen video file. There you go. Season one. Okay. I hate all of this stuff. I mean, like, this is what I hate right here.
Give me the loving.
Hate it. Right? Hate the give me the loving. Yeah. Okay. So old material. I'm the doctor.
At my fingertips.
And I'm one of my own. I'd love it if you came with me.
Who are you?
I'm the doctor.
Tell me, change me.
Okay, so they're saying this is the Clockwork Droids episode. Does look like it, doesn't it? Right? It does look like it. Then, you know, you get a bit of David Tennant in there. Look, we're it. We're real Doctor Who. Oh, we're real. But here's the thing. Where's the Jinx Monsoon clip? Because she is so shit in this. Oh, and there's also some more controversy about the lighting, the colouring. Which is, again, this was stupid. But where's the picture of Jinx Monsoon? There you go.
Completely.
I mean, you only get like a quarter of a second of it, but how shit does she look?
This place is completely mad. Thanks to you.
Yeah. Does not look good, baby. Does not look good. Oh, someone's not happy with that. Okay, I'm sorry, mate. What do you want me to tell you? Fine. Well, I'm up to. I'm only at 7 o'clock in the chat, man. I'm behind. Okay, let me get caught up with the chat. I think season one is going to be a disaster. I agree with you completely. Right? I think it's going to be more of a disaster than the Jodie is. Right? I really do, because I don't think the Jodie is was just like deeply incompetent, right, with the obnoxious ideology shoved in there to fill the void left by ability and story. This is much closer to genuine propaganda, right, because it's actually made with people with ability. Well, again, I just think they're all over the hill, right? I really do. That's what I'm getting most out of this rush. They're just all over the hill. When it comes to the TARDIS reaching out, that did anybody else have an expectation to break into Give Me the Moonlight? Kind of did. Matthew J is here. Doing Matthew J. Jack Noise. The Sodron is in. Yes. That trailer for Shooting Gap was new. The Gay Hour was so stunning and so brave that the BBC will make a spin-off. Skullshooty and the Naked Truth will also be so gay and so brave. Oh, I keep on. Can it's like not gay for one? In fact, why can't it just be asexual? Why can't Doctor Who be asexual? How would that be so terrible? I mean, that's why I put these heavily. I mean, other than they're funny and everything, it turns me on, right? But like, and it drives the toxic fandom insane. They go nuts. Oh, I love it when they go so nuts. Anyway, but why can't Doctor Who just be asexual? Like, why did Joe Grant have to meet a couple of lesbians in the trailer for, what was it, season 9 or season whatever Blu-ray is? Like, you know, you're less than 5 seconds in and you already established that the protagonists were all gay. Like, for fuck's sake. You know, if you have to keep telling us how great it is to be gay, I don't really believe you, right? I don't believe you. A Jewish furry, oh, yes. Quite a few of them about. They're all kind of furry. We're up to Darren. No, it's hello to you. Ashley LeBeckin, lucky they didn't bisexualize the Israeli flag. How do you bisexualize the Israeli flag? I don't know. I wouldn't mind watching that. Michael has gone through the floor. Oh yeah, I'm so old now. I can't drink like I used to. I cannot at all. No, I get like drunk to the point where I'm like, you know, I'm like throbbing, and then you know, when I'm like you know how drunk I like to get. You know when Sutek is going through the time tunnel at the end of Pyramid of Mars, that's how drunk I like to get, right? That's how drunk I like to get. And then I go to sleep. Regarding the bomb photo, what part of Central Bushy are you talking about? It was, let me see. Central Bushy? It was, I wouldn't really call it Central Bushy here, was it? Let's see if I can pull it up. We'll go to Google Maps. Google Maps. Well, I should read out the address I'm putting. Oh, yeah, it comes right up. Wait, I must have looked it up before. There it is. Here, I'll share the screen. One second. Share screen. Doink. So it is. There. That's totally my the house that I nearly grew up in. Right. I moved in there when I was like 14 or 15. Man, those trees are getting a bit thick, she cried. Yeah, yeah. So yeah, that was it. So where is that in Bushy? I'll show you exactly where. We go, zoink. So, was it Catsey Woods? Where was that? I had to go up to. Yeah, right, fine. So this is a weird, rickety downhill walk, and here's where the pub is. Hang on. You're going to tell me? Doesn't even show the pub there. Anyway, so then the 142 goes this way. And then this is where the high street is. And in that direction is Watford, right? So if that helps you out, right? If that helps you out, identify where it is. Please be a service. But why does it not show me the pub? Right? I don't know. That's really weird. Hang on. Bushy Gate. Is that where the synagogue used to be? I don't know. Street View. See if I can recognize any of this stuff. There, it's all. I've no idea where I am even. Blimey. Could be anywhere. Could be. I've no idea where the pub is. I've lost the pub. Is it down here? No. Hang on. Let me see if I can find the pub. Sparrow's Herm. That's the library. I thought it was over here. Unless, oh boy, that was the pub. That has now been made in the flats. Bloody hell. Well, that's depressing. Yeah, over here. Used to be a great chippy. right here. Is it still a chippy? Let's have a look. I understand. This is the most scintillating content in the world, but. Oh man, it's even got the same bloody name. Bushy Fish Bar. Fishish Bar? That was an awesome chippy. Oh, back in the days. And then there was a little corner shop over here. Is this it? They're all gone now. Blimey. Well, I suppose it's been like 30 years. But yeah, that's where the pub used to be. The Great Catsey.com. I have no idea. Okay, fine. video. Get that to screen. Doink. So there you go. I hope that explained it for you. BBC, look at Millie Gibson. Ignore the fact we sacked her. I know. I mean, everything about this is a PR disaster, right? There is nothing that's done well at all. Dr. Disco and the Fame Dancers. I mean, Dr. Gay, really? Ben's a trendy. I know Ben, who's transitioning to remain in the trend. Okay, I don't know who Ben is, but okay. Where are we up to? Amarose here. MAGA not Gaga, baby. MAGA not Gaga. But what's doing up with P Diddy? That's so bizarre. Is he being? Did he flee the country? And like. Why is the FBI concerned about... I'll pull it up one second. Where is it? Where's the article? Right, here it is. Prince Harry's involved. I mean, obviously. Is there a fuck-up going on? Yeah, better we'll out Harry and Meghan then. Because, man, can they fuck up. No, nobody can fuck up as royally as Harry and Meghan, which I think, all kind of makes sense. One second. Share screen. Doink. What is up with this? Prince Harry is dragged into the bombshell $30 million lawsuit against Sean Diddy Combs. Producer suing rapper over sex trafficking parties, saying Star's access to Duke of Sussex and other celebrities boost his legitimacy as his mansions are raided. Yeah, so apparently, like, why is the FBI concerned about trafficking? Like, the FBI, I mean, isn't the American government the largest human trafficker in the world now? Right? With all these children, they're, like, trafficking around America. It's so bizarre, right? So bizarre. You should vote for who Bill Gates tells you to. Well, that they just want to cut out the voting. And believe me, 50 years from now, if they get their way, they will. It'll be all gone. Fine. Amrose, anything? She can F up kids, that's Smita Becker. That's why she's working with kids. We're coming for your children. Yeah, well, and then we say, I want to keep you away from my children. They go, no, you're a bigot. Now we've got to take your children away and cut the balls off. Really? Yeah, that's the way it works, baby. That's the way it works. I mean, we can see the election attitude in the in miniature with Disney. Man, Disney's falling apart, right? Disney's falling apart, and it is so fantastic. Boring. Must be about Doctor Who magazine. The rabbi struggled through making Millie picks. It must be a tough time. Well, it does get hard. Let me tell you, it does get hard. Almost constantly, right? Almost constantly. James Monsoon cosplaying as one of the ugly steps. He's mixing in with Ursula from The Little Mermaid. Honestly, grot bags. I did this on a thumbnail ages ago, but grot bags would totally fit in. One second. Grot bags emu. And we get a picture of grot bags. Yeah, okay, 100%. This fits into the... Yeah. You want to tell me this doesn't fit into the current era? One second. Doink. Let me pull it up. This looks no more stupid than Jinx Monsoon to me. Yeah, one second. Share screen. Right, grot bags, a pantomime villain from an emu show, right? Does that look any more stupid to you than Jinx Monsoon? No, it really doesn't, right? It really doesn't. Oh, thank you, Millie, for coming back. Ah, everything gets better with Millie. Sadly, the pub's gone. Yeah, it is. I was like, what? Why would they get rid of the pub? What's wrong with that? And you in North London, what a shock. Oh, we're mainly in Golders Green. Actually, Hendon was a big one. I wonder if the synagogue's still there. Must be. Three boring problems. You need to read the book to understand what the Chinese politics and the history of it. That's Lonnie. I think they presented it quite well, frankly. Again, I'm on episode 5, and they're in the 80s, and Chairman Mao's dead. And people are, like, kind of moving on with their lives. It's interesting. Where are we up to? Ari Windsor apparently lied on the visa. Oh, man, please don't deport him, Donald. Please. Talking emu, we know there is a cult following from Nightmare series. I love Nightmare. Oh, my God. Nightmare is the greatest show ever. Can we get a trailer for that? Actually, I want to look at a couple of trailers before we get to Doctor Who stuff. ITV Nightmare. 1987. Is this like 4 episodes? I don't want to put on a 4 episode. Well, I guess I'll hang on. Doink. Nightmare. It was an incredibly inventive show, right? An incredibly inventive show. Where was it? I used to love this show. So much better than New Era of Doctor Who. And weirdly enough, they managed to go through the whole thing with nobody being gay. Right? How? How do they manage? I don't know. Right? I don't know. There we go. Dang. One second. Nightmare. Doink. Here it comes. Where is this? Doink. Video file. All right, so each week you had like a dungeon master with this bloke.
While others braver than yourselves challenge the secrets of my lair.
Oh, don't you love those 1980s Shakespearean tones?
A quest is now in progress, so here's a progress report. Our first team came from Bedfordshire, They boldly went and bravely tried, but though they bribed their way to fame, they still forgot the vital flame.
Yeah, let's get to the actual. So all this was on green screen.
Yeah, explosion.
Forward, go forward. Let's,
Yeah, so the kid's wearing a thing on his head so he can't see where he is, and it's just in a green room.
Stop. Now turn to the right. Now go forward.
I can see the table on the right. Stop.
So the table was real, I think.
Turn right. Then, can you describe
right.
the objects?
Right, this bread.
Right, and it's basically like, okay, and you had to answer questions from troll creatures.
I second. What is the man-like monster of the snows, whose face and form nobody knows?
Vulnerable snowman, you stupid kids! Bah humbug. I love Nightmare. Yeah, Nightmare is awesome. Where are we up to? Fine. There's a couple of trailers came out. Let's have a look, see if any of them spark any interest whatsoever. First one, The Penguin. Now, I didn't like The Batman at all. I thought it was like watching Batman Begins on half speed with the light turned down. I think what's his name as Batman was a complete failure, right? Just a complete failure. I'm sorry. Yeah, I can't remember his name. The Twilight kid. It just like, I mean, I remember when I heard he was going to be cast as Batman, I'm like, well, that's stupid. And I saw it when I said, well, that's stupid. Right, I found it long, I found it boring. And the most annoying thing, absolutely, about the Matt Reeves Batman was, what's the name, playing Penguin? It was, what's his bloody name? Hang on. Who's like a great actor, normally the best thing in whatever, Penguin actor, who is it? Not Danny DeVito. Oh. Colin Farrell, right? Colin Farrell as the Penguin, right? Colin Farrell as the Penguin. Now, I like the Penguin. I've always liked the Penguin, right? I like Colin Farrell. Colin Farrell's pretty good and great in everything I see him, right? So I like Colin Farrell. I like the Penguin. This him playing the Penguin was shit. He looked nothing like Colin Farrell or the Penguin. What? Well, why not have him be like either a Colin Farrell or be no, fuck you. You get neither. Anyway, so they're making a spin-off show with this. It seems like everything opposite to what James Gunn is doing in DC Universe, which is fun, right? James Gunn seems to be doing Super Friends in live action, right? Which for me sounds kind of interesting. Fine, so let's have a look at this Penguin trailer. Yeah, so honestly, making it like super grounded doesn't make it The Sopranos, just makes it a gangster show I'm not really interested in seeing.
When I was a kid, there was a gangster, real old school type, Rex Calabrese. He was a big deal.
I'm bored already. I literally am bored. Next chapter in the Batman. I didn't like the first chapter in the Batman song.
He helped people. You saw you on the street, he call out to you. When I'm 14 or something, he has a heart attack and dies. Still holding a cigar. In my neighborhood, they throw a parade in.
He looks nothing like the Penguin! I don't understand. I mean, like, I like the Penguin in Gotham, where it was a completely different, like a young Penguin. Right, that was cool. Burgess Meredith was more like the Penguin. This is nothing like the fucking Dan DeVito. More like, this is nothing like the fucking Penguin. And it seems like a mediocre gangster show.
Here's a freaking parade. I mean, it wasn't fancy, but it was a gesture. A show of love. What he meant.
And coming on. Great acting job by Colin Farrell. Oh, it's got one of Clancy Brown. I always like Clancy Brown. Great acting job by Colin Farrell. I don't care. I want to see either Colin Farrell or the cocksucking motherfucking penguin. Right? I don't want to see whatever this shit is. I want to see this cut price Tony Soprano. And he's not even an interesting character, at least what I saw in the Batman. He wasn't even an interesting character.
Can you imagine to be remembered like that?
Colin, mate, I hope you're going to be remembered by a lot of us. That just, it looks boring, right? I'm sorry, it looks boring. Yeah, do they have Gotham's Penguin? Do they have any him? Because he was great. It's a couple of balls. Yeah. One second. Because again, I found that, and I didn't even like the show Gotham, but I found the Penguin was the best bit in that, and it was a reinvention that was incredibly faithful to the original. Yeah, let me pull it up. I was downloading stuff. Yeah, well, while that's doing it, let me load up the, see if I get a copy of the Danny DeVito Penguin. Danny DeVito Penguin. I don't know which one to go for. Fine. Doink. Let me just grab that. Fine. Let's look at the Gotham one while it downloads. Video for, I mean, look, I am being mean. Maybe it's gonna be great, right? Maybe it'll be fantastic. It looks to me like it's shit.
Protection fees sound.
Sounds a little steep to me. What do we have here? A little family reunion? My invitation get lost in the mail?
No, this meeting is for grown-ups, so I'm gonna have to ask you to leave.
So I really like this take on it, like this like young thin penguin. All right, genuinely, I find it a good idea.
World is watching,
and we're live in 3, 2.
Mayor Cobblepot, as Gotham.
So, yeah, I thought it was a good success for a mediocre series. Let's have a quick look at the Danny DeVito one.
My baby! Did you miss me?
Again, this is sillier by a long way, but I like the macabre of it, and I like this penguin. Is this interesting? Was weird. It's about 30 years before Eduardo Rizzo appeared on the scene, but man, it's basically his penguin.
Did you miss me?
Great speech, Oswald.
Again, much more fun. I'm sorry, much more fun. The penguin will snooze around. And then I think more excitingly, they put out a teaser for Beetlejuice 2. Okay, so whatever this girl is, they put her in everything now. She is like the replacement for Winona Ryder, and who else? Christina Ricci. Any, like, dark-haired, sultry-looking young lady, right? That's it. What's her name again? I can't remember. So, I like the reverence that it's treating the original Beetlejuice with. Like, the authenticity. I get it, because it's from the same mind, I guess.
Daylight come and we want to go.
And I think having, was it Day or whatever the song is, right, as the central thing of the trailer, a great idea. That's a really genuinely good idea. That, I think that scene more than any really connects you to the original Beetlejuice in a much more profound way. So I take it, William Baldwin died in the original one. Who did she end up with? I can't remember. So she looks identical from the original. So it looks like what's her name is Winona Ryder. Mr. Tallyman, tally me banana. Daylight come and we want to go. Me say day, me say day, me say day, me say day. I mean, this seems like a very good. You know what? I said the same thing about Ghostbusters Afterlife. I haven't seen Ghostbusters Frozen Empire. From what I can see, it's a bit of a dud. I'm going to wait till it comes out on streaming before watching it, which is what I did for the Ghostbusters Afterlife. Now, I like Ghostbusters Afterlife, but it was a very different movie from Ghostbusters. But at least I felt it was an authentic continuation. Although I felt the same way about Matrix, whatever it is, Matrix 4, Matrix Revolutions, Matrix Resurrections, isn't it? Resurrected? I can't remember. I felt that was a very authentic continuation. Even though, you know, was nowhere near as good. So I think the build up to this has been fantastic as well, right? Normally when I see trailers and I don't have the main person here, I want to watch the trailer for, I get very irritated. But this is just everything about this has had the the DNA of Beetlejuice going all the way through it.
The juice is loose.
Yeah, and it's look, Michael Keaton is a great actor, and Michael Keaton wanting to do more of this role. I'm up for it, right? I'm totally up. Hey, hello. That one looks like a bit of a winner to me. I have to say this. Speaking of bit of a winner, this is truly awesome. Where is it now? Okay, where do I have this? Wait. Hang on. Got a couple of things. Well, there's far first. There's this thing which I saw online, which I thought was very funny, which is a nice segue into the main thing I want to show you.
Polite and smart and punctual, it once was good to be. You answered for your actions, and a woman was a she. You'd stand up for your people, if needs be, even fight. But now, if you uphold such values, then you are far right. Oh, we're all far right now, we're all far right now. Peterson, Rogan, Shapiro, E-I-E-I-E-I-O. We worship Mussolini, his portrait's in the loft. Must say Twitter, hi or Hitler, we're all far right now. Oh, you say you're in the middle, a moderate individual, a Gladstonian liberal.
I say, very, 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 very good green screen it's got going on here.
You once laughed at Donald Trump, you're probably a fascist too. There once was...
So, yeah, we are noticing, again... Being punctual is racist now. I've really got to get the clip. So you're racist now, are you, Father Ted? I hear you're racist now. I think they're given a day to after they fired Candace Owens, says OTS artist. I don't think they fired her, right? I think they came into a legitimate parting of the ways. Candace Owens, this is a segue, but Candace Owens is a matter of great discussion, right, in my neck of the woods. Because is she anti-Semitic or is she not anti-Semitic? I have most of my neighbors go, well, obviously she is, Totally. I am not convinced. Here's what I think is going on. I think we all have multiple drives in life. I think we have drives that come from our culture, things that are, you know, that's why, you know, if you meet somebody Jewish, they're probably going to be pro-Israel. If you meet somebody Muslim, they're probably going to be anti-Israel. And if you meet somebody Black from America, there's probably going to be, there's a lot of cultural anti-Semitism in the Black world. In America, it bleeds over to the English world, English Black world as well, right? But there's a lot of ingrained cultural anti-Semitism in the Black world, so I think that is certainly a factor in framing Candace Owens's worldview, right? I think that she always strikes me as being a very honest person, right? An honest person and an intelligent person, and somebody who's very metered by her Christian values, which I think she approaches very honestly, right, and very genuinely. The other thing about Candace Owens is this, that she's not afraid of a fight. No, it's like, it's more than that. She's the type of woman who gets her boyfriend beaten up a lot, right? She's never backs down from a fight, and has a combative personality because she's an intelligent and independent person, which I, you know, look up to, and I appreciate, right? I respect. And I think that Ben Shapiro, his passion for this subject, which I obviously understand, put her on a defensive. And when she put Candace on a defensive, she is on an attack vector towards you. So I think there's some unconscious bias going on with cultural anti-Semitism from the Black world, which has been a factor. I think a much stronger factor is getting into an altercation with both Shmuley Batech, Rabbi Shmuley Batech, and Ben Shapiro. And both of those, I feel, did a very poor job. In fact, so I think Candace Owens could have been a major asset to us here in Israel and has been turned into a detriment through sheer stupidity, right? Through ego and stupidity. So do I think she's anti-Semitic? I do not. Do I think she was fired? I also don't think so. I think her contract ended. And I think this issue made her realize that there is the Daily Wire wasn't the best place for her. But you know, generally speaking, I would love to talk to her. Oh my God. Would I love to discuss her views on Israel and the Gaza war? Absolutely. I would love to. But again, I just think she's been put in fight mode. And I think she's done very well for metering that, quite frankly. I don't think she's anti-Semitic. Anyway, that's an aside. In the same vein as that little video, I just saw somebody, who was it? I think Bobby D75. Somebody posted this to me yesterday on Twitter, and it is an absolute perfect rendition of what this new era of Doctor Who is.
Welcome to the Hooniverse, have a look around. If you like woke wankery, there's plenty to be found. We've got shitloads of content, some awful, some worse. None of it's worth watching, but it's also diverse.
So true! I mean, the old stuff, obviously, but it's also, I mean, like, none of it's worth watching, right? I just started listening to the new Big Finish release for the Sixth Doctor, the Quinn Dilemma. And it's not bad, right? It's not bad at all. But it's not good either, right? It's not really... I'm only one episode in, but listening to it and thinking, man, I would much rather listen to The One Doctor, right? Which is an old story, which I already have. The problem that they have is they saturated the market and they got... They saturated the market and you've got to have something better now, and they just don't. Anyway, back to this. This is awesome.
Welcome to the Hooniverse. Come and take a seat. We've got misandry and wheelchairs and a fan base filled with sheep. Bad Wolf have got this there.
They really are. Like, toxic fandom, they will just do whatever they're told.
Ones you can trust, just pay your TV license fee and shut the fuck up. Welcome to the Hooniverse, what would you prefer? Question marks or celery or swapping him for her? The losers on Twitter are bursting with rage.
And they do that a lot.
They've all got pronouns, but they no fucking brains. Welcome.
Wait. Whoa, what was that? Was that Mr. Trilby? Wait, let's see.
They've all got pronouns, but they no fucking brains.
It is! Who's completely straight, right? He's completely, totally straight, right? His wife and girlfriend isn't a beard at all. He is completely, totally straight and normal.
Welcome to the universe. Put your cares aside. Capaldi's where it ended. After him, it's all a lie.
Oh, yes.
We got fuckwits on YouTube and podcasts galore.
Am I one of the fuckwits?
And every showrunner's a hack and a whore. Welcome.
Wait.
Showrunner's a hack and a whore.
That is truly brilliant.
Welcome to the universe. Hold on to your socks. John Barrowman just posted some more pictures of his cock. We got race swaps and drag queens and diversity. Because the BBC sold out to Disney.
Oh, no. BBC and Disney are one and the same, mate.
Welcome to the universe. Have a happy day. Kiwi only got the part because he's black and gay. Fuck you.
I hate to say that, but yeah, I think that's what I think now. Honestly, that's what I think.
Image of you, BBC. Russell Gay Davis is a C-U-N-T. If you're a lefty loony or a Marxist moron, that's why hot chicks never fuck you when your cosplay always bonds. Which doctor who are you? Take this quirky quiz. Brissy just loves that fan when jizz.
I like Dee Briggs. I think everything he does from Big Finish, the only things I can listen to Big Finish and stuff he works on, and I like his work, right? I do have a lot of respect for his work.
Everything just turns to shit all of the time. Everything just turns to shit all of the time. Gallifrey's a tragedy, the writing is a crime. It's too late to regenerate, just let it die. Who cares about the...
You see, I love Doctor Who too much to agree with that, right? I just really want it to come back, mate. I just really want it to come back somehow, some way.
Universe, who gives a damn? Who cares about the Hooniverse? Who gives a damn? The ratings are embarrassing. Fuck you and your fam. But don't mind me, I'm just a grumpy old fan.
Oh, for God's sake.
Oh, good grief.
Oh, for Christ's sake, doesn't anyone know how to do anything?
Everything just turns...
This is really well put together.
To shit all of the time. Everything just turns to shit all of the time. Gallifrey's a tragedy. The writing is a crime. It's too late to regenerate. Just let it die. Who cares about the Hooniverse? Who gives a damn? Who cares about the Hooniverse? Who gives a damn? Shit occurs a disaster. Fuck you and your fam. But don't mind me, but don't mind me, but don't mind me. I'm just a grumpy old fan.
Oh, very good, grumpy old fan. Fantastic. Anything else there? Yeah.
Goodbye. It's good, isn't it? Hmm?
Thank you, Tom. Hey, 1 second. I just gotta apply that. Where are we up to? So just a reply. Just got a... Okay, fine. Where am I up to? Fine. So that I think is a pretty fair reflection of Doctor Who in 2022, 2024. I really do. I think it's a pretty darn fair reflection. But there's a lot more weirdness going on. Let's see where I can find doing. Where are we going to start? Is this it? Okay. I've got an embarrassment of riches of articles to go over, right? Oh, fine. Let's look at this first. Share screen. Doink. So this is interesting. There's a bit of a hoo-ha about... So it turns out Disney fucked up posting the Doctor Who trailer on social media. Seems they posted it without HDR to SDR conversion. I don't know what that means. The actual trailer looks right on Disney Plus. For your comparison, YouTube versus Disney. So that's YouTube. And again, however great they make it look, I don't really care because this is just... It's just garbage. But boy, fuck me. Well, it looks more juvenile, right? Whatever they can do to make it more juvenile, they'll do it. Man. So, wait, which is the Disney version? Is this the Disney version? No, it says Disney Plus there. This must be the Disney version. So this is the cheaper, nastier version? I don't know. It's weird. Disney now the only lifeline for Doctor Who? Let's have a look. Plans could see long-running program and even entire channels face the axe. BBC is set to announce their listener cuts and changes this week in an effort to get its finances back on track as the broadcaster faces a multi-million down funding slump at the end of the license fee. Well, you know, you wouldn't have to face a slump or even the end of a licensing fee if you hadn't decided to just cluelessly lecture the world relentlessly that, and you took everything everybody loved and you turned it to shit. So yeah, I do not shed one tear for the BBC going out tomorrow. BBC director General Tim Davey will tell stuff about his pledge to secure the future of the BBC via measures including a drive for more profitable partnerships like the broadcaster recently coupling with Disney on Doctor Who. Well, again, yeah, it's like saying, we're saved, we managed to hitch our wagons up to the Titanic, right? Not really the best of looks. So it's being a reflecting society, right? Oh, Doctor Who's got to look like the society. It looks nothing like the society, right? It looks like a society in what they want to create, but doesn't look anything like Western civilization. Western civilization basically are men and women that love each other and want to have babies with each other, right? And family units are still the best way of creating worthwhile people. So what's Stephen Moffat going on? Doctor Who writer Moffat, not the show's job to reflect society. What's he talking about? Doctor Who writer Stephen Moffat has shared he doesn't believe the show job is to reflect people's culture back at them. He believes it's the show's job to reflect people's culture back at them. Well, it's not reflecting mine. Okay, Stephen Moffat shared he doesn't believe the show's job. It's the show's job to reflect people's culture back at them. It really isn't. So you've been screaming that this is the entirety of everything for God knows how long. Earlier this month, it was confirmed that ex-showrunner Stephen Moffat would be penning an episode of showrunner Russell T. Davis and stars Judy Gatwer and Millie Gibson, first series of Adventures, directed by Julianne Robertson from Bridgerton, Orange is the New Black, Scandal. Now we're getting some insights from Moffat on how he's approaching his return to the long-running series. During an event at the Glasgow's Screenwriting Society, Moffat was asked about writing a show during a societal time that's very different from when he was showrunner, especially in terms of themes and representation. You mean, and also in terms of people liking the TV show, right? The themes and representation that you're alluding to has destroyed television, right? And absolutely destroyed television. I don't know. I think you're slightly foolish to think that it's your job to reflect society. I don't think it really is. I know people always say this, but why? Oh, Stephen, this one oasis of sanity in a swamp of insanity is wonderful. Moffat responded, noting that Doctor Who hasn't really changed that much over the course of a 6-year run. Well, up until when you left, right? When it said, let's make it unwashable shit. Do you really want your television to just a broadcast agreement at your face? Well, yes. Yes, they do. The guy who wrote this article, is it Addy Tantamith? written by Ray Fluck. Yes, they only want to hear their own opinion, right? If the Democrats can do it, right? If the left-leaning people of the world could do it, they would get rid of elections. They hate it, right? They absolutely hate other people's opinions, right? They only want to see their worldview reflected at them. Why? Because the worldview is weak, inconsistent, and makes no bloody sense, right? That's why they need to see their worldview reflected back at them, because they need to be bolstered, because it's just pure bullshit, right? It's pure, unending bullshit. Hasn't really changed much over the course of the 60 rounds. Do you really want your television just to broadcast your agreement of faith? Yes, you're right about everything. Here's your world. That's what they want. That's exactly what they want. Yes. I don't think you ever... here's your world. I don't think you ever... You just try and tell exciting stories. Moffat added. Don't worry. However exciting a story you write, Steve. Right, however exciting... They will have lots of shooty mooning to camera and being super gay, right? There's going to be lots and lots of super gay shooting, right? No matter how compelling a story you put together. Doctor Who is very much Doctor Who. Well, not for the last few years, I'm sorry. I can assure you, having read quite a few of the new ones, it's still that show. Excuse me? I've seen all the specials, and the last four specials, and it wasn't. I'm sorry, you had Starbeast, which was a retread of a comic book story from, 30 years ago, 40 years ago, which was, it was a very light, simplistic story with a tired, over-the-hill doctor, right? Which is what David Tennant was. He was a tired, over-the-hill doctor. And then, in the absence of any plot, if there's not any substance... They just inserted trans ideology. Oh, I'm male and female, everything together, so I can save the world. Oh, for fuck's sake. And I'm sorry, Yasmin Finney doesn't really sell it to me that she's a girl, right? She just doesn't. Like, maybe that big, thick, Judge Dredd short jawline and huge swinging cock may distract from that. Oh, why aren't you running the show, Stephen? That's the show. Tiny little details change, like he likes to suck cock a lot, right? That's just a small detail. Tiny little detail change, but basically he runs out of the TARDIS and says there's something terribly wrong here, and sorts it out for a while, right? Then he blows up everything at the last minute. Okay, Bob explained, before noting his perspective isn't the only one in the writer's room. I'm aware I'm the old geezer coming along to Doctor Who. But again, you're the only one with a bit of experience, talent, and ability, mate. There's also young people writing the show. He added, "I don't think it's ever really. I don't think you're ever really that engaged by that. Tell a story. It's not your job to reflect people's culture back at them. It really isn't. Well, it's the only thing that can be. Oh God, this looks like such shit. Right? This looks like such like." I'm not interested in this show. There's like TikTok Tate on Doctor Who. Hang on, one second. Let me go back to one second. Let me go back to that trailer. It's one of the bits I really hated in the trailer. That's another one, a bit I hate really hated in the trailer. Kind of hated this bit too. This looks okay. Hang on. That looks okay. But where's the scene in the 60s? That looked like a good effect shot.
Powers beyond the universe.
Well, was that, what's the name? Bingham? There's somebody in a wheelchair there. Oh no, that's what's the name. That's the kid they're very excited about. Not really very good. Where is it? Huggy Wuggies. Is this it? Hang on.
Everything is.
Yeah, this is not Doctor Who-ish, mate.
It's possible.
Yeah, this I really hate, right? This is the moment I really hated him jiving away to the Beatles. Everything is... No, not everything is possible, mate. Peter Richards is going to sink like Titanic. I think you're absolutely right, mate. I think you're absolutely right. Well, I turned back my 5 minutes. I had a quick look, and there's a thing that does things, and a perfectly ordinary word turned into something terribly and out of space. And there's a woman, and oh my god, Rossley Davis shares an Instagram post of the news of Moffat's run. I'm sick of Rossley Davis Instagram post. I'm just sick of it. Sick of them, man. I'm sick of you keep telling me it's going to be the greatest thing ever. Right, greatest thing ever, and it's not. Things that are, things are about to get pretty groovy. I don't want to be groovy. I'd rather be Doctor Who. Is there anything they're going to talk about here? Looking at season one and two, Yasmin Finney. We know Rose Noble. All this stuff. Nothing of any interest whatsoever, right? Nothing in it. So, look, the bottom line is, I think the sheen of this new era is fast wearing off, right? It's fast wearing off. Once you have Screen Rant go, oh, this looks like a bit shit. You're not looking good, mate, right? You're not looking good. Where are we up to? Fine. So, Doctor Who Season 14 release update. Confirms Chibnall era's mistakes are happening again. I've been trying to get this article. When did this come out? Oh, only for 2 days. No, this is more than 2 days old. It's been trying to get this article for a week. Doctor Who's new problems look very much like its old problems. They're subtly different. Season 14's release plan hints at repeating the mistakes that Chris Chibnall era. Following a less enthusiastic response to seasons 11, 12, and 13, 11, 12, and Flux, Rossley Davis was brought back to replace Chibnall as Doctor Who showrunner, the hope being that he will be able to weave some of the magic back into the 2005 modern relaunch. And that made the one really such a phenomenal success. Nope. Too obsessed with queer representation. Right, that's really the only thing going on in his head right now. Queer representation! Must have more queer representation! After a trio of 6th anniversary, 6th anniversary episodes. Yeah, so wait, I was just saying, yeah, those 6th anniversary episodes weren't good. You had the trans bollocks of the Star Beast. You had the tired retread of Wild Blue Yonder, which was dull. I mean, like, they made a big deal about it over nothing. And then you had the wasted opportunity of the Giggle, which would have been much better broken up into a three-part... If they made that into one story over three episodes. It was... a real wasted opportunity, right? A real wasted opportunity. Episodes and Christmas special. Doctor Who season one will kick off the new era proper. There's already plenty to be excited about. There's nothing to be excited about, right? The only thing to be excited about was Millie Gibson, and they fired her. The Tudor Cut was 15 Doctor bringing a warehouse full of charisma. Not anymore. I'm so over Shooty Gutwer. Right? I am so fucking over him. Right? You should have bought the goods before started constantly mugging to camera and telling us how great you are. Right? I mean, why does Shooty Gutwer constantly get on my tits? May I give you one reason right here? Doink. Shooty Gutwer getting on my tits.
People are not ready. Oh, this is so good. This is so good.
Yeah. It's just smart.
People are not ready.
It's not that great, mate. I'm sorry. It's not that great. Bringing me a wealth of charisma, and the full Russell Davis is thus far largely enjoying positive reactions. No, they're not. They're totally forgotten. They didn't receive any positive reaction. On the other hand, Doctor Who is already showing red flags that indicate the lessons that have not been learned by the makes of the Chibnall's reign. Season 14's plans is one such red flag. With Doctor Who upcoming run confirmed to be a seamless worldwide release with Disney and BBC. Okay, so he's fucked off about the New York-centric release, right? UK viewers will need to be awake until the early hours. Why season 14 release plan is continuing an old problem? So how did this compare to America? All right, fine. So the blah, 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 blah. I'm not going to read through the thing. On the other hand, this is great news for Doctor Who International, blah, 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 blah. So what do we do with Chibnall? The Chibnall era then doubled down with some festive fiddling, moving Doctor Who Christmas specials, modern franchise into New Year, and it felt horribly. It should be noted that while these changes coincided with Chris Chibnall taking the helm, Chibnall himself was not behind the scenes plotting the destruction of Doctor Who history. Yeah, he was. He said he actively didn't want to do the Christmas specials, right? Not the Saturday night and Christmas parts, at least. The BBC was ultimately responsible for scheduling Doctor Who. He wanted it on Sundays, right? Because this Doctor Who needed... His Doctor Who, first female Doctor Who, needed to be protected. If Peter Capaldi had that 7 o'clock Sunday time slot, his ratings would have been 50% higher, right? 50% higher. Where are we up to? So, season 14 is now returned to its familiar Saturday night slot, it's a massive caveat preparing streaming on midnight Greenwich Mean Time, once again, ignores the cultural value as Doctor Who in the general British TV. Absolutely. But, in so much more an egregious way than Chibnall did, right? I'm sorry. Moving it to the very protected 7 o'clock Sunday night time slot in between Country File and, Call the Midwife, right? That was only designed to help it, to make it soar. And it still fell completely, right? And I love the way they always scream victory in the first second, right? When that first episode got 11 million viewers, they're going, see? Stunning and brave, moving on, stunning and brave, brave and stunning, stunning and brave, so stunning, so brave, so stunning. Fine, so he's bitching about that. Ross David also already repeated a Chibnall mistake in Doctor Who's 60th anniversary. Bioregeneration is another timeless child-esque retcon. Yes, okay, I tend to agree with that, but I think that's his way of making it workable without erasing it. Yeah. Schmarco, you should have just erased it, right? And I think, yeah, if Doctor Who ever does come back, all this has got to be erased, right? I would start with a new. You know, it'd be really cool. You have a Doctor who's a mystery to himself. He has the TARDIS. He has a vague recollection of Daleks and Cybermen and other world, but he doesn't really know who he is or where he's from. And then, as these seasons go on, you get little glimpses of. You see, things from another universe that he used to live in, right? Things that you recognize. You see, a Troughton or something like that, a picture from another. And that will generate mystery while keeping the viewer involved and connecting to the past without making it slavish to it. Oh, man. I think that's the only way to really go up now. Breaking away from Doctor Who's usual TV slot is not the only problem for the Chris Chibnall era. Season 4 didn't carry over. The far most contentious story element was Chibnall's Doctor Who was the timeless child. A sweeping law change that rewrote Doctor's timeline, creating numerous problems, divided fandom. No, we all hated it. Divided fandom and never properly explained. Russell Davis' comeback was an opportunity for Doctor Who to move away from the murkiness surrounding the timeless child. But no, he had to dunk on the Chads. Right, no, we can't get rid of that piece of shit. Let's keep it. Now, Tudor Gatwood debut instead introduced bioregeneration, which is just stupid. Bigeneration, a sweeping law change that rewrote Doctor Who's timeline, creating numerous plot holes, a divided fandom, and never properly explained. Okay, Doctor Who's canon has always been malleable by the winds of its risers, usually in ways that can be swept under the rug easily enough. The Eighth Doctor comment being half human, and the Valiar, and why the Fourth Doctor regeneration needed the Watcher. But both the TARDIS Child and Bigeneration, however, are fundamental rewrites that completely change and alter the past of the past and future. Yeah, yeah. Again, if you can't write Doctor Who, which they can't because they're stupid kids, essentially being led by an insane man who has drunk too much Kool-Aid. It's rather than being inventive and working harder on their craft, they just say, no, we'll just change it all. No problem. Taking such a big ill-advised swing was a key mistake from the Chibnall's era. And instead of steadying the ship, Russell T. Davies has engaged his predecessor in a game of law-breaking top trumps, right? Seeing which of them could write the most seismic retcon. It's too early to write off Doctor Who season 14 as more of the same between Gatwa's performance, Unit's bigger role, and the Tantalizing mystery, a larger budget. Fuck the larger budget. That has not been good news. Larger budget. Plenty to get excited about Doctor Who New York. And nevertheless, Rossi David can no longer be viewed as a wholesale course correction, even if Doctor Who season 14 ultimately proves stronger than the Jodie Whittaker 3 seasons, which I don't know they're going to. In the TARDIS in terms of storytelling, other problems from that era seems to be going nowhere. Yeah, you know, and I think it's basically because of the BBC, right? The problems come from management, right? Which again, you can't write drama with your hands tied behind your back. What's this? So Doctor Who doubles down on a major Russell T. Davies law change ahead of season 14. Russell T. Davies has already made way since Return of Doctor Who. Trailer confirmed the showrunner will continue to do so. So what's this? What's he done? Doctor Who has changed a lot. Not really. Was it Moffat just said the opposite? His vision for the second sexual world has become clearer. Yeah, everything's gay. Every actor played a Doctor had to abide with a very familiar set of rules. That being said, each showrunner adjusted the show adjustments of the show law when they take the reins. However, the new trailer teaser shooting out was 15 Doctor may have more freedom when they than most where it comes to his adventure with Millie Gibson, Ruby Sunday in the TARDIS. One key part of the Doctor Universe functions remains largely in place from the for most of the show's run, but Russell T. Davies is about to shake things up. Doctor Who season 14 trailer covers is still running with Mavity. It's the dumbest thing ever, right? Isaac Newton unknowingly renamed Gravity. Yeah, I know, I hated it, right? Absolutely hated that. The second Doctor Who 60th anniversary. Especially while we go to the show, David Tennant's 14th Doctor and Catherine takes Donna Noble inadvertently influencing Isaac Newton's name on Gravity. Isaac Newton, who's now an engine guy, like an engine hipster. It seems like a threat. By the way, and his housekeeper is apparently the big bad for the season, or a big bad for the season. Well, it seems like a throwaway line. The Force refers to Gravity on several occasions in the way that heavily implies the past has been permanently altered. Time travel in Doctor Who rarely causes lasting changes to the timeline. So the whole situation of Mavity is a big departure from established formulas. Yeah, and like, how are you going to be able to keep track of that? Like, if time is completely in flux. New Faces features a scene that suggests time is being severely rewritten. Right here. We'll look at that one second. Season one. Yeah, here it is. Oh. Woo! Ooh! That's so stupid.
What if I change history by stepping on a butterfly?
Well, that's not going to happen, is it?
Oh, what's wrong?
Yeah, it was a dumb gag. It was just a dumb gag. Fine. Doctor Who's new time travel will make season 14 more exciting. It can, honestly, it could do if they realize it better, but they're really not. That's what they're really, really, genuinely, genuinely not. They have higher stakes than before. Well, again, it doesn't really make much sense. I think they're going to talk about the whole like history being in flux thing, right? I think there's got to be a significant part, right? But some people are somewhat excited. IMDb has 8 reasons season 14 is making the show exciting again. What are these 8 reasons? Oh, this is from Screen Rant. What are these 8 reasons, right? Let's go run through them. Doctor Who has a bigger budget. That is something that's killing the show. I am sorry. That bigger budget has made it look cheaper. It really genuinely has. So since it first began, it was distributed by BBC, blah, blah, blah. Revising then became a much more global phenomenon with fans around the world. And again, please, somebody tell me, what is wrong with these special effects? Let me pull this up. Where is it? Don't go there. Go here. Yeah. True Blood Lifetime. I love this trailer. It's a really good trailer. Yeah, for this bit.
I'll tell you what it will be. The trip of a lifetime.
Okay, what's wrong with any of these production values? They all look as good today as they did 20 years ago. Yeah, that extra money is not good news. I'm sorry. And it really hasn't done anything for the show either. Colin Archer says, I heard, read somewhere that part of the idea is that the Doctor, is something that the Doctor did means that racism no longer exists in history. Oh, fuck off! No! Please tell me that's not the case. That's so cringe. Right, it is so cringe. Hi there, what do you think will happen after season 1 if it bombs? Do you think they will show season 2 as soon as possible? Preach, Rabbi. I think no. I think they will it depends what's going on with Disney. Disney's in a lot of trouble, right? And they're probably gonna have a bold takeover happening in May. They got like a month and a half away. Yeah, 1 second. So it's a good question you're asking. Where is it? It was, I think, over here. Nelson Peltz, right? Nelson Peltz is going to is the investor that's trying to take over the board. The investor responds to the claims he doesn't know anything about the business. Okay, let's see what he has to say. They're saying, oh, you, and George Lucas has already even joined in. He said they don't know anything about making movies. You should leave it to the professionals. So he responds saying, because there's a big vote who should take over the board. Hopefully it'll be Nelson Peltz. And I think it will be. They say we know nothing about the movie business. We don't claim we do, but I think, don't think they do. The five big losers in a row, they've lost first place in animation. They've lost first place in features. It's time to change the management in those divisions, he told the Financial Times. So what about Kevin Feige? So I'm not ready to say Marvel, but Pelt said he's not ready to remove Kevin Feige yet. So maybe he's being forced in. Fans don't go to get a message. So he also happens to be Peltz, who also happens to be backed by Ike Perlmutter, a Jewish guy, who I think Peltz is probably Jewish as well. He used to own Marvel, and they had a big power struggle with Feige. People are going to watch a movie. People go to a movie to be entertained. They don't go to get a message. Yes, shut the fuck up. Exactly, shut them up. What about Black Panther and the Marvels? The article pointing out that Peltz takes aims at Marvels and Black Panther. Well, how did you think it wouldn't bomb? Right? The former lost Disney $200 million. The latter nearly half a billion. Fuck me. It made half a billion, was it? The former, which lost 200 million, and the latter made nearly half a billion. So that's an interesting comparison. Because I actually think Black Panther was a good movie. I really do. Marvel's piece of shit. The latter, which made nearly half a billion, less than the first one. Not to mention the Marvels also made nearly a billion less than Captain Marvel. In highlighting its powerful IPs, Disney also omitted 7 years worth of Marvel. Yeah, I know. Right, when they're going over all their successes, right? They didn't talk about their major things. Why do I have to have a Marvel that's all women? That's not I have anything against women, but why do I have to have that? Why can't we have Marvels that are both? Why do I need an all black cast? Peltz question. You know, and these questions are verboten, right? So if Peltz takes over, right? It's curtains for woke Disney, right? So they saw George Lucas back Bob Iger against Peltz. I honestly look at the world in a theological way and the way the energy is going, and I think the energy is going against woke Disney. I think it's going to go down. So the bigger budget, no, that didn't help at all. Tuna Cat was the 15th Doctor. I was willing to agree with you on this. I'm sorry. Hasn't bought it at all, right? Really genuinely hasn't bought it at all. Millie Gibson, great. Tuna Cat, well, not at all. Unit is back and boring. Unit is back and really boring and full of chicks with dicks. Yeah, no. It doesn't make it better, right? It doesn't make it. Russell E. Davis back. No, he's not. We have Rusty Davis back, but we don't have Rusty Davis back. You know, the 2005 Rusty Davis, who had his finger on the cultural zeitgeist of the country, right? We don't have that now. He's like, again, he's still thinking, oh, everybody loves chicks with dicks. We don't. Will you stop with your weird, perverted nonsense? Stephen Moffat is also back. Well, he actually said some good things today, so good news there. More inclusivity. Why does this make it better? Yeah, like, how does this help? Right? In what way? Let's read it, see what they've got to say. Being a show that first aired in 1963 and has always been progressive and inclusive, Doctor Who's past does feature a fair number of moments that would not be seen as favourable by modern audiences. So modern audiences can go fuck themselves. I'm sorry that you find this favourable. Here. Let's just get this straight here for a second. This is something they would find favourable. Let's pick out something that they would find favourable. We'll be fortunate to have a whole folder of these things. What should we go for? Let's see what this one is.
I'm going to do a quick little cheers.
Okay, this weird, perverted shit they find favorable.
And I normally do. I mean, I know there's little babies here, but close your ears. This is just a tradition that all shows normally do. So raise your glasses. Cheers to you. Cheers to me. Cheers to the ones that lick us where we pee. Yeah!
Cheers to the ones that lick us where we pee? What?
Cheers to me. Cheers to the ones that lick us where we pee. Yeah!
Yeah, okay, fine. So that's what you're advocating for, right? As opposed to fine. Yeah, that's it. Let's see if I can find it. Yeah. This is a story they say is problematic, right? Let's have a look at Trent. Here we go. Doink. Is this it? Yeah. Just grab this. Doink. So this is something they find problematic, and chicks with dicks, that's totally fine, right? That is all totally fine. But this is problematic, right? This one is problematic.
It's a stranger. A man whose thoughts were hidden. A man different from all of us.
Oh no, I can feel the yellow face! Help me!
He is a doctor, tall with wide, pale eyes.
Beware the eye of the dragon.
You don't happen to have an elephant gun, do you?
Why on earth do you want an elephant gun?
We're about to embark on a very dangerous mission.
No corks.
Son of death!
You stay here.
Beast of darkness!
Oh no! For the male gaze, help us!
I have made them larger and more savage than lions!
Oh, yellow face, help! No! So problematic!
Wang Chiang, I do hope that girl Leela isn't in danger. What have you done to her?
Nothing.
You probably wouldn't even have missed the sin, because, you know, you don't want to have the specter of evil short people.
Nothing yet.
Take my advice. Don't. I know you're a wanted criminal.
It's impossible for you to know these things. How can you in the 19th century know anything of the 51st?
Leela! Your so-called technology is the twisted lunacy of a scientific dark age.
There can be no escape for you. Let the talents of Wang Chiang drive your flesh!
Oh, that's just perfection. I'm sorry. So that's problematic, right? Problematic. Oh, fuck me, you fucking morons. Well, the show has always pioneered and pushed for changes. And has never been afraid to criticize modern politics or current affairs. The show has also come a long way in 6 decades. Yeah, backwards. It's come a long way in the first 5.5 decades. And the last half a decade went way backwards. When Russell Davis revived the show in 2005, he wasn't afraid to include, or still not afraid, elements that were not commonplace with the introduction of characters like Captain Jack Harkness, who had both an interest in both men and women romantically, sexually. There wasn't much romance going on. And again, I think that was as far as you could push it, right? I think where they are now with the gay doctor, no. While the modern series continue to push for more diversity and representation, there's still some elements that did not appear enough. Russell David made a very conscious and vocal effort to rectify it. Yeah, and it fucking destroyed the new era, right? I am sorry. Like, I understand your bonkers insane religion say it's a good idea to be a chick with a dick. I understand that, right? Most people are find it very off-putting. And it's not because we're not exposed to it. In fact, the more you expose us to that, the more off-putting and the less acceptance there is for trans people in the world, right? Russell made a very conscious effort, like Rose Noble, a chick with a dick, and updating the appearance of Davros to avoid associating with disability and evil. Well, fuck you, Russell D. Davis, you made it shit. Right? I mean, oh God, if you just turned it into a shit sandwich there, right there. With these changes, there are some uncomfortable and confrontational for viewers. They're not uncomfortable and confrontational. It's shit. It's diversity filling a void of where there should be content, where there should be good writing, where there should be character. It's just shit. So it's not uncomfortable or confrontational. It's just boring. Boring lecturing shit. It's also worthwhile to see them added in a more naturally presenting, more diversity and inclusion. Time travel done right. Yeah, let's change it all again. Beatles dying. Oh, fuck off. I can't even. New mysteries to solve. There is nothing I'm excited about this new era. Like, literally nothing, right? Literally nothing. Merchandise, still quite interesting. So this is interesting. This new part work, which I find quite interesting. You get you build a full 82 centimeter tall Dalek, which seems bizarre, with stunning details. We get free gifts. You get a binder. I don't call that a free gift. All right. So let's have a look. How much is it? So how many issues is this? Question, let's look at your FAQs about the collection. What is the how many issues are in the collection? 140, right? So how much is this? So 140 issues. How much is it a week? When will it be, how often is it published? You get what, one a month? Weekly. Okay, so you build your Dalek in, well, still about 3 years. So each issue, $11.99, right? So, well, let's do the math. So we have so it's 140, 140 divide at times 11.99. So £1,678. Wait, so minus from that, £12. Minus 12. £1,666.60, right? So how much is it? How much is a Dalek if you buy a full-size Dalek? This Planet Earth, I believe, is where they sell them. Fine, Daleks. Shop Daleks. So let's do Apple Silent, New Era Daleks. So it's 3,995. Okay, so this is essentially plus delivery, right? So that's going to be expensive. So it's not a bad price, right? It's not a bad price. So it's like it's okay. So £1,600. Let's go back to looking at it. Fine. So I thought it was going to work out and be more expensive. So over 140 weeks, that's 52. So about 2 years, 8 months to get your bits of the Daleks. You get a TARDIS mug. I mean, really? TARDIS mug with delivery 7, a free issue, a keychain. I mean, this is really shit. I mean, this is really shit. A binder for the issues, which you're not going to really want. Okay. High quality model with spectacular features. Assemble the detailed Dalek model part in the formidable 1-2 scale, including interactive functions, faithfully reproduced from the TV series featuring die-cast parts, built-in special sound effects, working lights and movement, all operation environment. Well, that's actually pretty darn impressive. I have to say, I think it's pretty darn impressive. So we have, exchangeable claw. And I loved it when I saw the claw because it really reminded me of the movie Daleks, right? Modeled on the Time War first seen in 2005. Built-in lights make eye glow. Okay, lights flash, accompanying sound effects. The mutant is a bit unimpressive. Maybe I would go with the mutant with a bit of gloss, I think, to make him look a bit more goopy, right? Make him a little bit more organic. Discrete wheels allow for remote control movement. Head and shoulder sections rotate. Okay, and you get fine. Hang on. Copy link address. Let me download the movie that comes in it. I don't know. It seems is this gonna work? Hang on, let's have a look. Yeah, it did. Doink, let's download this. Like I got my you get a full Dalek for a grand and a half on eBay. Really? So the problem being, I did one second. Let's have a look. eBay full size Dalek. How much is that? Oh, yeah, you're right. Look at that. plus another 1,000 posters from England. Well, that's still not bad. If I had the money, I'll totally buy it. They said they got to see a new era Dalek. You can get, I'm seeing lots of bits. Hang on. It's sort from most expensive. Highest price. Well, it can't be that much more expensive to get a new era Dalek. Okay, special price grey model. Do you have anything else? So there's this one. Shawcross inspired Paradigm Dalek plywood GRP. Okay, so if you don't get the officially licensed one, you can save yourself a fair amount. It's cheaper, right? It is cheaper. Okay. So let's see, seal. Okay, no. These are not similar items. I mean, I guess they are, sort of. Anyway. Back to this. Oh, fine. We're looking at the video that came with it. Video file. Oh, I thought I had the screen open. Let's have a look at their features. Oh, problem. Thank you so much for sending that... Welcome to the Hooniverse. I played that earlier. Avon lives, baby. Exterminate. So you need to have somebody with it so you can see a sense of bloody scale. There you go, a remote control unit. Okay. Do you think they just haven't built one yet? So it's 82 centimeters high. 700 to 800 pieces approximately. Yeah, so they don't have a working eye stalk, right? Because that's not real. That was special effect. Working lights! I feel like when you're driving past a motel and they say it's got colour TV. Exterminate! Ah, and he's just showing it open up. But here's a question. Is it always like, do you have to get, no, yeah, no, it is. That's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. Exterminate. Yeah, there's nothing there to show you the scale of it, which is, I think it'll give you a much better idea of what you're getting inside your magazine. Crap, nobody cares about. Literally nobody cares about. And then step-by-step build instruction, first four issues. I mean, okay, so the first one you get comes with parts for the front panel of the dome, including unique nameplate. Then you get the eye, and then you get more eye stalk. So basically, it's a good idea they give you like something recognizable in the first few weeks, right? Otherwise, you're like, oh, this is going to be shit. subscribe and choose your stunning issue. One, if you want a Dalek, one. You receive your first view on, and then you'll get an issue every 28 days containing four issues. What is it? There, from then on, you'll receive another delivery every 20 containing four issues at £11.90. So you're paying £50 a month, essentially. You'll receive a free Dalek binder. I don't know, who cares? When are we subscribing to the collection? Yeah, no. What else do they have at Hatchet? Website button. Okay. UK website? No. Other questions? Cancellation? Yeah, they'll be sucked if you get three quarters of the way through and it get cancelled, right? That will totally suck. Man, yeah, it's I look, if I lived in England and you know, it was the Trump years and I had money going on, I'll be like, yeah, totally. I will go. As things are now, not so much, right? Not so much. Fine, let's have a quick look around at stuff. Okay, I didn't talk about the new Titan comic, which I'm really not interested in. This is a funny little story. BBC will stop using AI for promotion of Doctor Who following complaints. Deadline reports has no plans to use AI again. Well, what about all the bots you use, right? You are you counting those as the AI you're using, because they're clearly using bots. Bleeding Cool. I think it's Stephen Moffat actually saying something good. You know, quite rare. More bollocks from Screen Rant. Doubling down on law changes. Fine. I don't think there's. I think we're going to wrap it up there. Right. Is there anything interesting going on in the genre world outside of Doctor Who? Really? Actually, no is the answer. Amazingly, no. Not much is going on at all, baby. Not much is going on at all. Fine. Other than, you know, scintillating entertainment here on YouTube. Tonight, however, let me pull this up, because this looks really good. Right? This is what I'm genuinely excited for. Is this? Let me put it. I'll put it up and let me put it in the chat. Doink goes there. So tonight, our friend Dan on the Type 40 has scored himself a bit of a scoop, right? Bit of a scoop. The a interview with Ian Levine. So that's going to be starting in about 48 minutes, right? 48 minutes. I'm looking forward to hearing it. I say I would be interested. I am interested. Okay, I'm totally interested. Fine. So here's a link to that. Scoot over there, baby. Scoot over there and check it out. I am back Thursday, ladies and gentlemen. Thursday with more cyber filth to enrage the wokies. And boy, do we enrage the wokies. We love that a lot. Until then, I'm going to say good night. Good luck. And be your God walk.